Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will make a video about my top 5 colored pencils. I pick out only my artist colored pencils and maybe I will do a budget friendly top 5 later in the year. I'm not sure how I feel about it, but today my top 5 colored pencils. And in front of me is my Unicolor limited edition set of colored pencils, and I'm in love with them. I put them on the 5th place, shared with another pencil brand, and yeah, it is one of my favorite pencils, but it is on the 5th place because I'm not using them to color with that much. So let me show you. I keep the protection foam in it. I really want to keep my pencils well protected. It is a limited edition set and there were only made 5,000 of them, and yeah, they are very nice pencils. I think they feel close to Polygonus pencils. I can pick out one that I've used already. They have the same core size and nice vibrant colors, and I've used them. You can see some of them I've used, not all of them. And yeah, I'm really liking those pencils, and I like the way they are numbered, so you can easily put them back in place without too much hassle. So let me show you all those beautiful colors, and they are simply on the 5th place in my ranking, in my top 5, because I'm not using them that much. If I knew they were available and I was able to get them open stock and replaced, then I'm sure I will use them so much more. The 3rd layer, beautiful blues, beautiful pencils, and yeah, I love them. I'm so happy to have them in the collection. 4th layer with beautiful pastel colors, and I barely touched them. You can see there were some colors that I've used on a picture in a Kirby book, I think. And the last one, all the gray tones, and this odd red one, I'm liking it in the set. That there is just one red one at the end. Like I said before, this set is sharing the 5th place with another brand. Let me move this one out of the way. It is very heavy. And I really want to be careful with it. So, it is sharing the honor with the Holbein Artist color pencils. I have them in the cardboard box. And of course in this lovely wooden box set. Let me open them. And I keep everything inside. I'm really liking it to keep my sets complete. So in the top layer, there are those leaflets with information about them. Those pencils are soft. And they don't work very well on every paper. And that is why they are in my top 5. The set in the wooden box set, I've not used that much because I like to use them in the cardboard box more. I pick them simply out more often, and of course there is protection foam inside. And the smell of those is amazing. I'm really liking the smell of wood and the good pencil brands. A lot of them have those lovely wood smell. Color selection is great. There are enough variation in grays for my coloring style. There is enough brown. Well, maybe I would love to see some extra browns, but it's a good color selection. And of course, the bottom layer of this box got a lovely, lovely pastel colors. And some nice skin tones. If you're looking for some unique skin tones. I'm liking this cork one. Oh no, it's not this one. There is a cork one. It is this one. I'm loving it to use it in skin tones. Lovely pencils. I can watch at them for hours. I simply don't use them that much, that often, because, yeah, they don't work on every paper. I like them on the Camilla de Errico books. I like them in the Maria Trolle books. On the Hannah Colson paper, I don't like them. And yeah, I love to color a lot in the Hannah books, so maybe that's why I keep them so much in the closet. Then the fourth place. Because the Holbein and the Michibichi pencils were sharing their spot. It is a set by Garand. And I'm really liking those pencils. Especially on Eerie paper. The books by Eerie. Oh, I love to use them on the paper. It is the Garand Light Facet. And those pencils are so soft. Those are kind of crumbly, I must admit, and you will use a lot of the pencil if you are coloring with them because they are very soft. I don't have used them very often, but you clearly can see the use. There were two in this row. You can see I like to use the greens, and I think I've used them maybe on 5 pages, and this is the result I got in the box, and yeah, I made already a big dent in them, and that makes them even more expensive in use. Not every paper they are great on. Sometimes they feel a little slippery on certain paper. I like them in the Hannah Colson books a lot. They are working great. I like them also in the Eerie books. If I use a base layer of watercolor under it. So, yeah, using them on top of watercolors on smoother paper will give you nice effect. And the thing I think is very cool in this set is this little booklet on how they are made. And I can look really hours in this little book and read about it over and over again. There's something so satisfying about all those pencils. So I keep it nicely together. Then third pencil place is the Caran d'Ache Luminance. Those are, yeah, I use them a lot, I must say. I'm really liking those pencils. I like them on the Curry paper. I like them on the Camilla, the Errico paper. And in this set, there were some duplicated colors. Some extra. And I take them out. And I added in the 4 new colors that were not fitting in the other sets. There is an extra set with 20 colors. And there are those 4, yeah, extra colors. And I put them in this set. Most of the time I take out my cardboard box because I have it longer. And I try to use them all before I dive in this one. But sometimes I will have this feeling and color with them. It is just so nice to pick up a wooden box set. I'm really liking my wooden box sets. So you can see some of them are used. And of course the greens and the browns. And those pencils feel a little bit more chalky. Some of them are even a little scratchy on certain paper. And I know not everyone is a huge fan of them, but yeah. Definitely suiting my coloring style. The only downside is those 2 blenders. I'm not a fan of them. I showed it before, they will yellow over time. And I think you can see the color difference between them. This one is way more yellow and this one is white. And if you put it on top of your coloring page and the yellowing is starting on your picture, you can see, yeah, that won't really be a great thing when it's happening on my pictures. I won't be happy with it. That is why I don't use them. And I'm not a fan of those blenders. But for the rest, yeah, I'm liking it. Those are quite expensive, so that's why they are on my third place in my top 5 colored pencil sets. And yeah, I think they are a wonderful addition to my collection. And I am enjoying to use them a lot. Ooh. On to my next set, on second place, and that is simply not because of the quality of the pencils. It is the Prismacolors. Because I like them on almost every paper. And they are so easy. They are in my carry bag by Derwent. And I take my bag with me all the time. So I'm using the Prismas all the time. And that's why, yeah, I know them so well. And picking them up and knowing the colors is really relaxing for me. And that's why they are in the second place. I picked out my backup set, so they are all brand new. They have a little chemical smell, a typical one for Prismacolors. And I remember the first time when I was opening this set, I was not happy with them. There were some pencils really, yeah, broken. But I can show you. This one, for an example, there is some crack in the wood in the painting. There were some pencils that were bent like this. I already replaced them, so they are not longer inside. Cannot show you. There are some little things that I'm not that fond of. With quite some expensive pencils, because those are almost more expensive for me to buy than my Luminance color pencils. In the Netherlands, it's quite hard to get a set of Prismacolor pencils. Luckily, I found some of them used secondhand and I had a great deal on them. Those I've ordered, yeah, a few years ago, and I keep restocking them when I, yeah, use some of them. To keep it complete, so I always have my backup pencils. I use them enough to, yeah, justify it for myself to have a whole set as backup. Also because of all the videos that I'm making and I like to color. And when you down to a little nubby, I just don't want have the stress about that I'm not able to finish the picture. That is why I keep a whole set backup. And also I'm not able to run to the store and get new pencils. I have to order them, to import them, and yeah, because of the price for me, those are the second place. Also because of some of the breakage and little issues that Prismacolors known for, and of course I've experienced it, and yeah, I still like them enough to put them on my second place for the list. And then, of course, my favorite color pencils of all time. They have a little special place in my heart. Those are the Faber-Castell Polygonos pencils. A wooden box set. This was my very first set that I got from my husband when I was starting, yeah, more seriously in adult coloring. And I wanted to try out some different pencils. Let me open them. They come in this lovely, lovely color palette. And you can see I've used them a lot. I have a backup set for most of the pencils. But for me it is easy to go to the store and pick them up. Those are still under 2 euros for me to get each pencil, so that's a great price compared to some of the other pencil brands. and why they are on my, the first place in my list. Just because the feeling of getting your very first pencil set, it is great. It is excitement. It is, very good memories. And when I like to take my time with a coloring picture, I pick up those pencils. They go great on almost every paper. Only coloring with them takes some time. You have to layer and layer and layer. And sometimes you like to get some quicker results, especially when you are making a video. Not everyone is liking to watch those slow, long videos by building up colors. And it can take some time before you see the results of it. But looking back at my pictures, when I've used and took my time with them, those pictures are some of my favorites. And combine that information all together, those really make up my number one adult color pencil. And I'm using them not all the time, but you can see I use them enough. And it's funny to see I'm barely touching the red colors. And some of the yellows are still brand new, and others like the browns I replaced already several times. So I'm always liking it to see what colors you use more. So this was everything on my top 5 color pencil list. And let me know, what is your favorite color pencil and why? Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I really hope to see you next time. Bye!